always there when you call. Always on time. It's almost like there's a radar that goes out when you're a new girl in LA. Like, the guys just know you're fresh meat.
Talk to me about that name, names, give me situations.
Instantly, I just started meeting people.
And you met?
The first person I bumped into out was Ja Rule at a club. And it was 5 days of nonstop sex.
And that was just the beginning. In her book, Confessions of a Video Vixen, Karrine Steffans gives steamy details of bed-hopping with music mogul Sean Diddy Combs, R&B artist Usher, and NBA superstar Shaquille O'Neal, who she claims she met on a blind date.
I open the door and it's Shaquille O'Neal. That's how my life works.
What happens when Shaquille walks in?
He says, the furniture is too small. I can't even sit on this couch. I had regular furniture. I didn't have oversized furniture made for a 7-foot man. So tomorrow we're gonna wire some money into your account. You'll get a big screen TV, you'll get some bigger furniture, you'll get a bigger bed for yourself, and you're just gonna redo the whole thing.
At that point, are you thinking, I'm gonna have to do something to get this sofa?
No.
So in your mind, he's just being generous.
He said to me, you're my woman now. There you go. $10,000, you're my woman. All my life, I had been doing things to get money. You know what I mean? Even when I was dancing, I was giving that service to get that money. And so I had a hurry.
And when you say service, what?
Just the dancing, just the being on stage, taking your clothes off to get that $1,000.
Karrine Steffans grew up in the Caribbean. There was little money and not much in the way of role models.
You know, my mother would just carouse. She'd be gone for 2 and 3 days at a time. I wouldn't know where she was.
Today, she's a single mother in Hollywood, raising her young son.
I'm a super mom and a super cook. I am a super lover.
And a pretty good dancer. She raised the heat in some high-profile music videos and a big-budget movie.
Wait, hold on. What are you guys talking about?
You get a role in a movie, A Man Apart, with Vin Diesel, but you co-starred with Vin Diesel.
Off-screen?
Off-screen?
Yeah. It was so romantic. He's a very striking man, and his presence is overwhelming, and I thought, God, he's so beautiful, and his voice and his body and the thing.
Talk to me about your encounter with Bobby Brown.
Bobby spent about 6 months with me here in Los Angeles. At the time, him and Whitney were separated.
But still married.
But still married. So he would always find a way to come to LA and always find a way to be with me.
And Whitney knew about this?
She's aware of everything her husband does, and I'm not the only woman. You know.
Bobby Brown actually at one point told you that he was a member of Al-Qaeda?
Bobby had a really tough night one night and was just out of his mind and told me he was from Al-Qaeda, that President Bush was looking for him, that we had to catch a flight to the Middle East immediately. And he was upset when I said I wouldn't go with him.
Bobby has come out and said, you know, this woman's lying. Karrine is lying. She's
but then
a big liar.
And then he also said I should sue her. And then he said, maybe I'll leave her alone. Because there's a picture of him and I cuddled together in bed in my book.
Shock me. Tell me something that's not in the book.
There are big names that are having unprotected homosexual sex with their boyfriends, going home to their wives and giving their wives diseases.
See, that's the kind of stuff
that
if you wrote about or that they know you know that you may reveal in an interview, that might get you killed. Are you that brave?
I'm that brave. I'm that brave because I have no fear and I have no shame. And I don't live that way. I don't live my life that way. It's an awful way to live.
Almost all of the women who I spoke to who knew that I was doing this interview said, oh, you know, you got to ask her about rating these guys and who was good, who was bad, who was
I always say this. I was the best lover. I was the one that made them good. Baby, be mine.